Of the approximately 250 million, 2,500 lakh people that are eligible to cast their vote in the upcoming 2020 US elections, just 1.4 million, 14 lakh, may well decide the fate of the next president of the United States of America. Unbelievably, they are Indian Americans. As Americans choose between Donald Trump and Joe Biden, Trump thinks he can get a larger share of the Indian American vote this election, even though traditionally 65 to 70% of them normally vote Democrat. He believes this turnaround is possible because of just one factor: India's Prime Minister Narendra Modi. The leaders of the two largest democracies openly indulge in bromance and mutual admiration.
I like Modi a lot.
Donald Trump is a great president, welcoming each other to their countries in the most extravagant manner, be it the Howdy Modi event in Houston, Texas, or Namaste Trump in Ahmedabad, Gujarat, which served to strengthen Trump's position among the Indian American Hindus in the US, pacifying them in other ways too. While on his India visit, he stayed mum on Kashmir's status and the CAA, citing them as
India's internal matter,
and also turned a blind eye to communal riots happening just a few kilometers away from where he was staying in New Delhi. The bonhomie was in full view recently when Trump applauded India's lifting of the export ban on hydroxychloroquine, a drug used to fight COVID-19, promising that this act of kindness
would not be forgotten.
He kept to his word and returned the favor by sanctioning 6 high-speed SUV-sized machines capable of conducting 6 to 8,000 COVID tests at once, a machine for which there is a long waiting line, but gave India preference. 2 days after he returned from India in February, Team Trump spent tens of thousands of dollars taking out ads targeting Indian Americans, playing on Modi's 2014 slogan,
Ab ki bar, Modi Sarkar!
Ab ki bar, Trump Sarkar!
Singling them out for praise.
Indian Americans are the titans of business, masters of the arts, and can innovate technology like nobody else.
While Indian Americans make up one of the most successful and richest ethnic groups in the US, with a median income almost double the national average, by numbers alone, they do not seem capable of deciding electoral outcomes. And minorities anyway overwhelmingly vote for Democrats. More than 4 in 5 voted for Hillary Clinton in 2016. So why is Trump losing sleep over less than a million votes?
I must get the Indians to vote for me.
Simply because of the peculiar nature of America's election system, known as the Electoral College, where the winning candidate has to get a minimum of 270 electoral votes out of 538 that constitute the Electoral College. The US has 50 states, and each state, however big, sends exactly 2 senators to the House of Representatives. The rest of the 438 electoral votes are decided in an election where the winner takes all. So if a candidate wins California by 1 million votes, 1,000 votes, or even 100 votes, he takes all the 55 electoral college votes or seats belonging to California. In the 2016 US elections, Hillary Clinton won California by a huge margin, over 3.5 million votes, getting all its 55 electoral votes. But Trump won states such as Florida by relatively narrower margins, just 100,000 votes, but still got all its 29 electoral votes. Because she won populous states such as New York and California by large numbers, Hillary Clinton polled 2.85 million more popular votes than Donald Trump. But Trump stole the White House by winning 30 smaller states by narrower margins and getting to 270. This is why in the US, it is possible to lose the popular vote but still win the White House. The same thing happened in 2000 when Bush 43 became the US president, even though Al Gore had won the popular vote by over 500,000 votes. Analysts believe 4 US states, Pennsylvania, Michigan, Wisconsin, and Florida, which collectively have 75 electoral votes, are most likely to determine the outcome of the 2020 presidential election. In these closely fought states, every single vote matters, especially those of Indian Americans. By hailing India, Trump wants to swing those few thousand Modi supporting India voters to his side, and thus tip the balance of electoral votes in his favor. In fact, Salab Kumar's Florida campaign for Trump in 2016 may have tipped the balance of votes in his favor, helping him get elected. Trump's victory margin in Florida, 113,000 votes. Indian American voters in Florida, 125,000. Democrats' words and actions may also inadvertently help Trump. Leftist Bernie Sanders bashes Indian government policies.
India's action in Kashmir is unacceptable. The US government must speak out boldly.
Democratic Congressman Ro Khanna.
Every American politician of Hindu faith must stand up for pluralism, reject Hindutva, and speak for equal rights for Hindus, Muslims, Sikhs, Buddhists, and Christians.
While Democratic Congressperson Pramila Jayapal even introduced a resolution in the US Senate against the abolition of Article 370 and CAA.
We urge India to end the restrictions on communication and mass detentions in Kashmir.
These anti-India sentiments have hurt many Indian Americans, and Trump is taking full advantage of the discontent against Democrats. But some of Trump's actions too hurt the Indian American community, like restrictions on H-1B and H-4 visas, 70% of which are given to tech-savvy Indians. And his actions and deportations against Indian students from Karnataka caught misusing the CPT program. But he balances this by appointing a host of Indian Americans to important posts. Nikki Haley was formerly the US permanent representative to the United Nations. Ajit Pai, chairman of the Federal Communications Commission, and Seema Verma, administrator of the Center for Medicare and Medicaid Services, among many others. And ask Indian Americans to help revive the US economy. Sundar Pichai, Google, Satya Nadella, Microsoft, Arvind Krishna, IBM, Sanjay Mehrotra, Micron, Ann Mukherjee, Pernod Ricard, Ajay Banga, MasterCard. However, Joe Biden may counter Trump's campaign among Hindu voters through Amit Jani, his Asian Pacific Islander outreach director, whose father Suresh Jani and Narendra Modi belong to the same village and joined the RSS around the same time, and who also founded the Overseas Friends of Bharatiya Janata Party USA in 2008. The 2020 US election is one of the most divisive in recent times, where citizens have risen against excessive police brutality, and the coronavirus has made public campaigning impossible. The elections are Trump's to lose. While polls show him trailing Biden, he won from a losing position against Clinton. Earlier, it was Cambridge Analytica's fake news scandal that turned the tide in Trump's favor. Will it be the Indian Americans this time that help him cross the line? Bizbo's limerick. Are Indian American votes important enough? Does he actually love them, or is it a bluff? But it's the Electoral College, voters acknowledge, that may decide the winner when times are tough. Subscribe to Bizbo and click on the bell icon to get notified whenever Bizbo releases a new video. Sources of all our information is listed in the video description section.